Congratulations on the 8th blockbuster.
Thank you so much.
I mean, like, what are you doing here? You know? So I saw it yesterday, packed hall Sunday afternoon. It's incredible for the second Sunday.
Yeah.
How are you celebrating? I know you don't like to party. So do you do anything or do you just buy one more car and go back to work?
I've not bought it yet, but I might
gift
myself.
One more.
It's like, for me, you know, it's when I see my team, when I come that Friday evening or Saturday morning to office, the day.
Did you know Friday evening ki ye hit hai?
Yeah, you come to know. By Friday evening, you come to know ki it's going to work. How big, you don't know.
Right.
That's a surprise which comes as the day passes. But when you see your team happy, who have worked so hard, you know, and you can see their walk changing, you know, their attitude changing. Yeah. All kids working with me. Yeah, little swag in them and, you know, with attitude, the whole team, you know. Everyone in the office, I must say. So that gives you happiness, you know. So that's like an achievement. That's more than a party. Party keeps on happening. I'm not a very party person.
Right.
So we have a small get togethers. And like Karan, today evening, Karan has called us home. You know, so we all are going. That's more important. And that makes me more happy than a party. Like celebrating and just like one evening we all meet and the whole industry comes and everybody has their own point of view. And but for me, people who have worked with me, been there with me, that is more important when they are happy.
Yeah.
That's like a party for me.
But do you pat yourself on the back? Do you say, well done, Rohit?
Not really. It's like, and I just, it's like a little really crazy sometimes. I sit and think, why am I not reacting to it? Why it's not hitting me? You know that, okay, it's
right.
Like it's done so well and
it
people
is.
Are liking it and
yeah.
You will not believe, like, it's been 4 days now, the film has released, I think it's been 10 days the film has released, I believe, and it's been last 4 days we have started working on the next script already.
Really?
Last night I left at 11 o'clock from here.
Because you're writing the next
because
one.
Because we were writing.
And
we started writing.
Suryavanshi.
That's Suryavanshi. More than a party, like the celebration will go on for a year, you
sure.
know, when you're making your next film, everybody is that has that good energy, everybody is in that high,
yeah.
you know, the whole team,
yeah.
and so much happiness around, you know, you can't say, I feel that happiness can't be celebrated in just in one night, you know, it's like the theater owners are happy, the people working in the theaters are happy, and the team is happy, the industry is happy, you know, so it's been not a great year for commercial films.
Sure.
And then a film like this coming and doing so well, that happiness is something else.
So, Rohit, I think it's definitely your best film.
Everyone is saying that. Yesterday,
yeah.
Ajay saw and he called me and he said, "Ki best film hai teri."
Definitely. It's definitely your best film. And you know, what I am really intrigued by is your ability to almost guess where we, the viewers, will laugh, where we will get emotional, where we will maro a CT. Understand how you do this. Okay, let's just talk. No, I'm just fascinated. I want to understand Singham's entry. Right. Now, no Rohit Shetty hero can just walk in through the door. So,
yeah.
obviously, the whole Jeep
yeah.
has to come crashing through.
Yeah.
Then we get the close-up of his leg coming out. Then he throws his glasses that go
yeah.
round and stop on that bonnet. How do you plan this?
I think that's been our schooling. That's how we've been trained to make commercial films. And it's like it's like build up to that euphoria. You have to create, you can't just suddenly come, you know, and do it. Like you have to give that build up, you know. So to give a high, you have to give that build up to the audience, you know. Okay, something is going to come, something is going to, and then it comes, you know.
Right.
There's a difference between giving a shock and there's a difference in giving a high to the audience, you know. Shock value has to come, like, you know, like out of sudden, instant. But to create that euphoria, you have to give that build up that something is coming, and then he comes, you know. So that build up is important.
But where do ideas come from? Like, do you sit down? Are you just thinking about this all the time,
yeah.
and suddenly
yeah.
something will inspire?
Yeah, yeah, it's always like that. How do I give a build up? You know, what the background music will be there, what the shots like. His entry was decided, it's not like it didn't happen on the set. This was decided when we were writing the script. That
of
this
course.
Is how we'll enter.
Of course, it's these, too complex these, for
yeah.
that. Yeah.
And this will be the music, like for this film, if you've seen, when you saw the film, the police station action music was recorded and we shot that action, a dummy action in a studio, like a song. That's
right.
why it's so well
it's choreographed. Yeah.
It's choreographed.
Right.
Before we started the film,
that
was the first thing we shot. So everything was planned, like the background, how it, where, and I used to tell Sara and Ranveer, you know, mark this, like when you get up, people will clap and
you know it, don't you? You know it, right? Because that's
they, now when in theater we were watching, they used to give me a look. How, you know? I don't know. It's just that schooling, you know, okay, angles and right. build up, background right. music, and this will give a high to the audience.
Huh.
For me, it's become, I won't say easier. But rarely now films are being made like that, you know.
Yeah,
there are
yeah.
very few films.
Yeah.
You know, like for me, if I may say so, this has become a parallel cinema now.
Correct. You're right.
You know, that's why people are enjoying so much. Huh. Rarely you get to see this kind of cinema
right,
now.
Right.
So that's why, and it's become cool now. Like with this, with Simmba, the kind of people are reacting in a multiplex.
Mm.
I feel that mass has become cool now.
Right.
If you make it in a right way.
Yeah.
You can't
yeah.
go overboard like how Simmba was.
Right.
So this is the new palette of a commercial film, I believe. This year, there must be around 8 or 10 commercial films
yeah.
out of 230 or 40 films.
Like full-on masala.
Full-on masala films.
Yeah.
But you
yeah.
have to make it cooler.
Yeah.
And
right.
now you have to just take it forward. But at the same time, you can't go overboard. You have to have that limit, keeping them in mind, the new generation in mind.
But listen, it's not just the new generation. I was just telling you, my mom loved it.
Yeah, yeah, that audience is there, but the new generation coming in. You know.
So you have to make it sort of appeal to
all.
Right.
Yeah, and
right.
then like I've seen so many on social media. Mm. Like my ADs were showing me like girls, you know, with whistles. They're clicking pictures. Okay, we are going to watch Simmba with that CT.
So it's an experience.
It's an experience.
Yeah.
I think
yeah.
because very few films are being made now.
Yeah.
It's become like parallel. Commercial has become the parallel cinema now. So if you make it right, it will work. Like it's doing overseas, it's doing so well.
Yeah.
It's strange. Like people are sending me, my distributors are sending me videos from Canada where people are whistling and cheering in Canada.
Right.
It's quite
right.
strange.
Yeah. So here's my theory about you, Rohit. And tell me how correct I am. Okay. So my theory is that as a storyteller and as a filmmaker, you're really turned on, and I don't mean sexually, of course, but you're really excited and invested in a sort of hyper-masculinity. You love strong men. You know, all your low angles and all the slow motion walking. And it's like the way Yashji used to shoot women.
Yeah.
Remember? You know, like in
the white sari in
the
Switzerland.
White sari and the Switzerland, and that was then our highest sort of bar for beauty
yeah.
and for sensuousness. And it was a Yash Chopra heroine.
Correct.
I think there's a Rohit Shetty hero. Is this a correct assumption?
The many young guys have called me like, you know, okay, now you shoot us like that.
Yeah.
I think, again, as I say, like, I make action films and for an action film, you have to have that, you know, there was a time, if I tell you, like, when I sit and think about youngsters used to follow someone. Youngsters used to follow an Akshay Kumar, or youngster used to follow a Sunny Deol, or for that matter, Shah Rukh Khan, because they had that style.
Right.
Now that style is going, thinking that it's cool. It's not like that. Whom a young boy or a 16-year-old boy will follow now? That guy has to have that style.
Right.
So, you know, who he'll look up to, you know, okay, I need to wear like this clothes, or I have to have a body like this, or I need to walk like this. You know, so I maintain that. I still feel that it works for my film, you know, not for every film. But for my hero has to be a bit larger than life. Where
right.
a young guy sitting or an ordinary man sitting should think, yeah, this is me. Mm. And I want to be like him.
Right, right.
So always that is there in my mind.
Which is why Simmba sort of has that much swag and and talks like that and is very funny. The
very
whole
funny, yeah.
tell me something I don't know.
Yeah,
you
yeah,
know,
yeah.
all those taglines and
exactly.
the things that we go home with. So of course the flip side of this sort of great love for men is, I think, that you're not very interested in women. Okay, in the women characters.
Okay.
Okay. In the women characters. So
no.
so hear me out. Hear me out.
Huh?
So I think that, which is why, Rohit, I feel like the whole rape angle in the film felt like your intentions were great. I have no issues with the intentions. I just feel like the way it came across was that all of it was finally only to serve the men. You know, the women were all in relationship to Simmba. The one who is the judge is somebody who's sort of almost emotionally blackmailed into taking a decision in that very emotional scene in the courtroom.
Mm.
And in the end, you have a female, the judge, blaming another female, the mother, for something a man did, who's the rapist son that she had. So I just think like it just came across as something that was more a a lip service rather than really felt, because inherently your world is about men. It's not about women.
No, it's not like that. If a policeman wants to shoot someone, he's a guy, he's a hero.
Right.
Now, he wants to, my point of view is that this will only end till the time you don't take a
tough stand. Sure.
It's not going to end.
Yeah.
We will come out with candle march and we'll do all those things and then we'll forget about it. Hmm. That's the harsh reality about it. Today, my point of view of Simmba was, I'll tell you what, today everybody is scared to drink and drive. Today everybody wears a seatbelt. But
right.
People are not scared to rape. I come from that point of view. It's because today the laws are so strict of drinking and driving that if you're caught, you're in the jail. People are scared. People keep drivers or they don't drink and drive. You know, like this New Year, if you see, it was the rarest and the least
sure.
people caught in drinking and driving.
Yeah.
But rapes are not getting, the numbers of rapes are not getting cut down. So
right.
My whole thing, my whole point of view came from there.
Okay,
till the time, like in 92, 93 and the mid 2000, I'll tell you my perspective when I started this film. In 2000, there was a time that every underworld was calling every film personality,
correct.
Every builder.
Yeah.
If you buy a car,
I've experienced it firsthand. Yeah.
You buy a car and you get a call.
Yeah.
It only started getting, it. The whole of Mumbai city got clean when they started killing them. When the encounter started happening. When there was a fear. So here I'm talking about the fear. And if you see, the judge doesn't say ke har ma. She says har ma aur baap.
But wo last dialogue hai. Uske pehle to maa ko hi blame kar rahi thi.
Kyunki Durva ka baap hai nahi na, to kaise usko swarg mein jaake usko blame karna padega. She has to die for that. And if you see, people blame that heroine is only there for dancing and romance and all that. But the other characters, what about the other characters? What about the other women? They also have that importance. Today, I sit like, I might sound a little arrogant, but I don't need an issue like rape to make a film hit.
Sure.
I've proven 13 films, 8 are 100 crores, 2 are 200 crore. This one is going for a 200 crore.
Yeah.
Before that, All the West and Golmaal returns and Golmaal is also there. So like I'm sitting at 10 blockbusters.
Sure.
I don't need such a pathetic thing to do.
That you'll just use it.
No.
Right.
That's wrong.
Right.
But do you see where
the criticism is coming from? Are you able to see that?
No, it is, I must say, like, you're one who's saying about this and 2-3 people who have written about this. Other than that, if this was the case, there are so many women calling, there are so many women writing on Twitter that this is what should be done. They are not feeling it like that. Because I feel they are not analyzing it. They are just getting entertained and they are saying, okay, this is his point of view.
Right.
If you start analyzing things, then every film has that thing. Like in Pink, then why Amitabh Bachchan is coming as a lawyer? Why not a lady lawyer?
Right.
Like tomorrow, if I want to make a film, if Simmba was a girl, she would have killed. But if she was an officer, I'm talking about the police point of view, that this is what should be done, and that's my point of view. I know there will be controversies with this point of view also.
Yeah, I was going to come to that.
No, but this is my point of view, and I'm not worried about the Twitter world.
Hmm.
This is my point of view. A Nirbhaya thing happens, you have to shoot them. You have to create that fear. That is my point of view, and it's solo my point of view.
But Rohit, you don't think it's dangerous when your films, I mean, you're so successful and the messaging you're putting out there is that encounter killings are okay. Is that not problematic?
For me, no.
No?
No.
You're clear about it.
I'm clear about it. If tomorrow, God forbid, and it happens with my sister or my mother, I want to kill that person. I'm clear about it.
Really?
I'm clear about it. And any person who's just a family, see, it's very easy to talk about some victim and give you a point of view, go out with candle. But what's going with her and her family, only they know.
Of course.
So I'm talking from that point of view.
Mm.
That the fear needs to be there. You need to create that fear. The whole agenda of Simmba is to create that fear in that ruthless people.
Which Singham has also done.
Yeah. I believe in that. And that's my point of view. I don't care what Twitter will write, what few pseudo intellectuals will write. But the girl who's going through that, only she knows.
It's very easy to stand
with a candle
yeah.
and write big write-ups and blogs and articles. But what she's gone through, what her family has gone through, God forbid if it happens with my family, someone in my family, I will go and kill that person.
So
it's straight and clear.
Right.
And that was my point of view to make a film. That's why I'm angry with few of the journalists who are saying that I've used it as rape.
Mm.
Today, sitting with 10 blockbusters, I don't need to do that.
No, of course not. Of course not.
I don't need to do that.
But you know, Rohit, just to play the devil's advocate, to say that the criticism might be that the women don't have enough agency, right? Finally, it is all, the rape serves a man's evolution.
No,
right?
It's not that. And see, again, we are not talking any commoner picking up a gun and shooting.
Right.
We're talking about cop.
Right.
And Simmba is a cop. Now he's a man. Hmm. He would have been a woman. If I'm making a woman-oriented film, or...
Will you someday?
I want to. And for
that... Let's do Ocean's 8, na? You get,
no.
get like Deepika, Anushka, Priyanka. Just do it.
Oh God, so many. 8 heroines?
8 heroines.
And 10 staff, like 80 staff. Oh God, no.
Hair and makeup, that's
no,
it.
You no, can't do it. I can't deal with that.
No, but seriously, would you have a really strong female character?
For me, see, Chennai was not a Shah Rukh Khan film.
Of course.
People forget that.
Yeah.
For me, Golmaal 3 was not again an Ajay Devgan film. It was a Kareena Kapoor and a Ratna Pathak and Mithun Chakravarti film.
Right.
That's how we write. And then because it's commercial film, so people don't go into that theory. Like Golmaal 3, I never thought that it was an Ajay Devgan solo film. It was a Kareena Kapoor and a Ratna Pathak and a Mithun Chakravarti's film. Same way, Chennai was a Deepika Padukone's film, you know. And she got the maximum credit also for that film.
Yeah.
So it's not like my heroines are not like they are the only for dance and song. It's never like that. Till today, Anupama, except for my first film Zameen, I never had an item song in my film for that matter. Let me tell you.
Yeah, I know that. Yes. Tell me, will Suryavanshi, perhaps there's room for a really tough female cop?
No, there's no cop because we are.
He's an ATS chief.
But there's no cop in that film because we are planning something with a lady cop. Let me tell you that.
Ah.
I'll direct that or not, I don't know. But we are developing that also.
Nice.
To create that, complete that whole world.
Right. So Simmba and Singham will hopefully have.
Later on. It's
later
like
on.
2 years, 3 years down the
right,
line.
Right. Yeah. Right. Nice. Okay. I really look forward to that. I want to see that same entry.
Yeah,
that
kind
she's
of.
She's gonna come out, throw her glasses. Okay.
That will be something else only then I'll do if I do.
Yeah, we need all of that because we need somebody to like women in the way you like men. I think it's amazing. But tell me, you know, I remember chatting with you like maybe it was a year, 2 years ago, and you had said that you couldn't do the Ram Lakhan remake because no two heroes were willing to work with
each
other. So how did you get Ranveer and Ajay and Akshay in the same film?
You know, because they come from that school. Ajay and Akshay come from that school where two heroes, three heroes were fine. The new generation has the problem. You know, and I wish they start working together because everyone has such a great fan following now. You know, that the reach will be bigger. Mm. The film will be bigger. And it's high time they start doing that, you know, two big ones, like two, the upcoming stars should do a film together. It's high time. I don't know why that insecurity is.
But it's still not happening.
Tell me one big film happening like that.
Yeah.
They will say, no, aisa nahi hai. They will promote each other's film on Twitter. They will click pictures of party and put. But tell me one, two big stars, two young big stars doing a film together. Tell me one film.
Right. Though I was really excited about Ram Lakhan. I mean, it just... It was...
Oh, we'll make it something like Karan was always saying, yeah, humare paas wo bhi hai, don't forget that.
Yeah, it was so good. But what was it like to work with Ranveer, who's, you know, I think willing to do whatever it takes. I mean, you could see that from his performance, that there was no barrier in his head about...
Yeah. He what was like, he tells me I was born to do this.
Yeah. I believe that. I think that's who his inner core is.
Yeah. And I think he's very hardworking. Mm. And he's very inspiring, you know. I've done so many films, but still young guy. But he inspires you. That's what my ADs also say, you know, okay, that he's an inspiration. The kind of hard work he puts in a character. It looks easier on screen, a commercial film. And so many palettes, you know. There's emotion also, and there's real serious emotion in this film, not like many other, like my other films, but there's comedy also, there's action also. It's like he had a tough time, but he really worked hard on it, you know, and very honest, I would say, as
what
an actor.
What do you mean?
As an actor, very honest with his performance. He just lives the film. And I shot with him for 93 days, but not a single day I could see him like coming like, you know,
tired.
Always with that smile and energy. You're working for 18 hours, 19 hours. Again, you call him next day morning, but he enters with that energy. And so positive about everything, you know. The whole approach, like, I think he was the only one. We all were scared. We all knew that it will do well. But he was, from day one, he had, like, this is a blockbuster film, I'm doing. He had that approach. And I think he has that approach for all his films. And that's why he's so successful.
Tell me about some of the dialogue in the film, you know. Just, you know, I laughed out loud when... At the end, when there's a confrontation between him and Sonu Sood, and he's saying ki family meri hai, and he says, "Mera baap hai, meri maa, meri behan hai, bhai nahi hai, but ab to tere bhi nahi hai." You know, it's just it was so cheesy and so funny. How do you come up with lines like that? Who's like the master of
this film? What we wanted to do is all the confrontation scenes. There were hero villain whenever they come together, standing in front of each other. I don't wanted it to look like Singham. That's why one first time when they come after the interval, you see the film, the tide turns and takes towards the mother. He goes and he's sitting with his mother and all the conversation is happening with the mother. So that's how I wanted to change that whole thing. So one confrontation happened like that. The second one we wanted people to clap. The whole thing was that this will come and I had told Ranveer about it.
Huh.
The moment you say that's why the camera also goes like that. Bhai to tera bhi nahi hai. Because I know that people will clap on that. They will cheer on that and that's what happens.
Yeah. It was like everybody just cracked up and started clapping. This is, I think, your superpower as a director. That you know this. You know where people will clap, right?
I don't know how it comes, but yeah. I can't claim that I know, but I start feeling
it. But your instincts are there.
Instincts is that here they will clap, here this will happen. Yeah.
So, as you become more and more successful, and now you are the most successful, how do you keep these instincts in place?
It's like practice. Going to theater, watching films.
Observing. You still do that?
Always.
Really?
This year, I missed a lot of films because I was like back. We were like for 5 months. We were just shooting this film.
Huh.
Then I was in Argentina for Fear Factor, so I couldn't get time. But I see to that I'm in the theater, and I'm like, it's like a. It's not a. I don't go to enjoy a film, but it's like for me, it's like I observe people, studying people.
Huh.
Like where they are laughing, what they are doing, how they are reacting. When the film is in satellite, how they are reacting. When you meet people, what they are saying.
Right.
You know.
So you're researching all the time.
Yeah, it's always like, okay, she told me this, he said this, the kid said that, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, and strange things come up. So like, one lady at the airport, she told me like, you know, when your film is there on satellite, I just leave the remote and go because I know there's no such scenes like I have to be there with the remote.
Right.
So that keeps my, okay, so this is the one of the reason why it's working on satellite, you know, why women and family audience come and see my film.
Hmm.
So all the small thing, really, I keep a note of and then use it in my film or keep that in mind. You know, okay, these are the things. Like if some unknowingly sometime happens, you know, like a double meaning dialogue comes in or some gesture comes in, we immediately cut and we... We just go back and, you know, we say, no, we are not going to do this. It's not nothing wrong, I'm saying.
Yeah.
But for my kind of audience.
It's not yours.
So that consciously I'm like always working, you know, okay, what worked, what didn't work last time, what we should do. It's always there, working.
And do your assistants who write with you, your ADs, do they have the freedom to be as critical as they want?
Yeah. And that's what I love and that's what like... There's so many times they'll come and say, we don't require, like we had a big action sequence before the interval point. One of my AD, and we were shooting the film and that sequence was supposed to be shot in the next kid. And he came to me and he was like, I don't think we require this. Again, we had a meeting, why did he say that? And actually we removed that sequence.
Really?
Yeah, it happens. It happens all the time. It's like an open door policy because a director can go wrong, you know, if you have. And I believe like more people working with you, with an open door policy and with an open mind and where they are not scared to share their thoughts, it works always. It always works for me.
But you have no sort of arrogance that now I know?
No. That nobody, you know, that can never happen with a director. At the end of the day, the film business is such, if I may say so, and that nobody knows anything. We only work on judgments. Like if Simmba would have not done that well, in North, people would have said that winter is not chal rahi.
Right.
It's doing well. 20th December, no film had released. In
That's
years
right.
and years
That's
and
right.
years.
Yeah.
So now suddenly everybody is saying this is a new date.
Correct.
So it's like we all work on theories and nobody knows anything here. Otherwise, every director will just make hit films. You know, or a flop director won't make a hit film again. At the end of the day, everybody is just working on instinct. So I can never say that I know everything.
But what do you, you know, in fact, I was just talking to Ayushman and he was saying, because he's had such an amazing year, he was saying, but actually success is a lousy teacher. You really learn from failure. But knock on wood, you haven't failed for a while. So what do you learn from success?
Success, I think it's just a fuel, you know, I feel like at the same time, it becomes your, how do I put, like, it becomes a barometer, okay, this has worked and this has not worked, and sometimes it also happens that this has worked but this was not right, it's fluke which has worked.
Correct. And which you, I know you told me about one film.
Golmaal Returns.
Right. Yeah, which is
film.
The one that you said you didn't like at
when
all.
When I saw the film, I was like, "Arey, kya dilwale?" Like when we saw, I'm like, "Bhago, niklo idhar se." Film ka bhi, matlab, you know, and so many things were happening. Because it was like we had so many things happening. The release date was coming, and right. then so right. many issues happened in that film. You know, let's Monday morning we were like, "Forget it and niklo bahar yahan se." So you know, you come to know.
Right.
With films, so it's like the previous fit. Will always teach you something. It's not that only failure teaches you. Yeah. Failure may teach you that, okay, these are the things you don't need to do. But a success can teach you, okay, these are the things what you have done, which has done well. Now you have, it's time to improve more.
Right.
You know, it's not just failure teaches you, even success teaches you.
So you're constantly improving.
Yeah, yeah.
So what's next, Rohit? What is the next big ambition? Now you're creating an entire universe, which is a first for
cinema. Now we're getting into production. We've been planning it for like 1 year now, and now that will start. My AD's working on few things. We have directors from outside also. Like we have directors in our company, like established directors working for us now. And so now I think after Suryavanshi, I see that happening. 3-4 films being made in the company because the scripts are being developed, and none of them are like my films. You know, that's what I'm liking about it.
So it won't be your school?
No. It can't be my school. Because I don't want that to happen, you know. I want them, where production is concerned, I want like all kind of cinema to come out. And so that's what is happening in the next, I think next year we'll start with all those films. And I'm looking forward for that.
And what's your big dream for yourself?
I want to create a studio like Yash Raj.
Really?
Yeah. And I'll do it. If it comes in my thought, then it happens.
Wow.
In the next 10 years, it'll happen.
Like a full-on
proper studio. Like it's my dream to create a Yash Raj. I'll create it in 10 years.
But before that, you're making Ocean's 8.
Ocean's 8, no, but what the
one female
cop movie I want to make. We have a subject also. That's why.
Really?
We do have a subject, so I want to do that. We will do that for sure.
Nice. I look forward to it, Rohit. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
If you like this video, subscribe to Film Companion.